Welcome back, grade 12s. We are with Better at Business. What are we doing? Well, we are looking at investments. We looked at our strategies for investments, and we are now going to look at our investment options. We're going to do the first four investment options, and then there'll be a part three with the rest of the investment options that you could choose from. Okay, great. So, the first investment option that you could look at, remember, it's high risk. We've dealt with this in the growth strategy for investments, is equities. Now, what is equities? Equities is buying shares in a company. The company needs to be listed on the JSE in order to buy the blue chip company shares, or you're going to be buying from the company, a private company that will then say, we have X amount of shares available, this is the price of the shares, and so you buy a stake into that company. You can also buy equities from a previous owner that sells shares. So those are the three ways you can get shares: a listed company on the JSE, or you buy from shares from a company directly, or you buy from a previous owner. Remember always, with investments, we're going to be looking at three key headings: risk, return on investment, and the time period. So what is the risk with equities? Moderate to high risk. It is an unknown in many ways when you are investing in companies, because you actually don't work for the company. You don't know what's going on. So there is a risk with regards to that. If you were investing in a company in Russia and the Russian war came out, you would then have been at very high risk. What is the return on investment? Well, it's the increase in the share price. As more people are buying shares, it's all about supply and demand. When you have high demand for something, your pricing will go up. And how else do you get your return? Is dividends. When the company is making a profit, they release dividends and you will then get some money from that. The time period for equities is long term. Definitely looking at 10, 20, 30 years. So it's good to get into equities quite young, because you've got time to play around with it. Very important, and I've seen this in a question, is what influences shares? What influences the share price? Your country's economy will influence the share price. If things go wrong, if all of a sudden we have no electricity, people are not going to be generally buying South African shares, because how would a manufacturing company operate if there is no electricity to operate? Government policies, any kind of policies that are changing, could affect your equities. The industry performance. So the retail industry could be going, you know, the profits are really not looking good. And I think if you look at South Africa, again, with Eskom and electricity, the profits are not as high as possibly last year, based on people having to buy generators to ensure that the store stays open, and it's petrol and it's diesel, et cetera, et cetera. So you look at your industry performance. The financial performance of the company. What is the return on investment? What is, how is it looking healthy? What are the ratios looking like for that company? Confidence in management. If there is a lack of confidence in people that are managing the company, people are not going to invest or buy shares. Any social elements that could affect, that will affect your company, AIDS, COVID-19, anything like that, it all affected us. Any legal changes, and then media coverage of that particular company. If you're getting bad PR, people are not generally going to invest in something that is receiving a lot of bad PR. Okay, the next investment option is called a debenture. It's a new word, debenture. And all it is, it's a type of debt instrument similar to a company owing you money, because you are going to be because you're going to be paying their money. Let me explain it. So it's called an IOU. basically the company will say to you, we have debentures available for 50,000 rand. You then say, okay, I will get a debenture for 50,000 rand. And how does the company pay you back? They will pay you interest, and they will work out an interest rate based on that 50,000 rand, as well as having to pay back the full amount that the company is lending from you. So you operate like a bank. So you have interests that you are, that they are offering you. You lend them the money, they pay you the interest back every single month, and you are able to get some sort of payment from them. It's not secured. So the only risk also with a debenture is that if the company cannot pay you back, for example, they are liquidated, they go under, you have no claim for a debenture. One may directly buy debentures from government or any company. Some debentures are also traded on stock exchanges, so that investors also have an option to purchase from the secondary market. Okay, so let's have a look at our three headings. Risk. The risk is a higher risk because it could be affected by your interest rates, in terms of what the company is able to offer you as interest. Another risk is, do your homework on the company, because if the company goes bankrupt, remember, you have no claim to it. You lose all the money. What is the return on investment? Well, the company will pay you interest. There is no capital growth, so your money can't grow. You get a fixed interest every single month. A company can offer you a higher interest rate. Okay, so that, again, would be the higher risk, high interest rate. But, again, you'd have to have a look at the company and make sure that you are comfortable with the company. Interest income is taxable, so you will still be taxed on your interest income. And unfortunately, with a debenture, it seldom beats inflation. So your return on investment, it will seldom beat inflation. The time, generally over a long term. There are three types of debentures. The first is redeemable. So they are going to pay you on a predetermined date. You've lent them 50,000 rand. They've said in 2 years' time, on the 30th of August, they're going to be paying you back everything that they owe you. So that's redeemable. Irredeemable is they never pay you back. You get interest indefinitely for a period of time that will eventually cover all the costs and then some. Convertible type of a debenture is that it can be converted into shares at a predetermined date. So you, the company will then offer you shares to say, we will pay you interest for X amount of time, and then we're going to offer you shares in our company, and you can then start getting dividends. Okay, the next investment option is called RA, which is a retirement annuity or a pension fund. So a retirement annuity, you take out over and above your pension fund because you know your pension fund is not going to get you back into the same position as what you are now. So you need more. So a retirement fund, a retirement annuity provides income to a person when they reach 55 years old. You pay monthly into this fund, and then a lump sum will be paid out to you at the time when you are 55 years old. The government can't provide relief for South Africans. So that is why they give us a tax relief. They cannot give us a pension fund. They cannot look after us. We are not like the dole where they can provide money and funds. South Africa is not in the same bracket as that. So how does the government try and help us? They give us a tax relief. If you take out a retirement annuity or more pension funds or whatever the case is where you are trying to look after yourself when you are older, they give you a tax relief in the sense that you minus that amount from your net salary, and then you're only taxed on the amount minus retirement annuity or pension fund. Because remember, our tax system is progressive. The more you earn, the more tax you pay. So how does a pension fund work? Everyone pools into a contribution. That then gets invested on your behalf. When you retire, you receive a monthly income. So, for example, Checkers and all the Checkers staff will pool their money into a pension fund. They will have an investor who will then invest that money into what kind of investment? Hopefully a diversified investment, hey? Diversification. So they'll have a little bit of everything so they can get enough return from it. Once they retire, they receive a monthly income. What is the risk? Okay, so the risk with retirement annuities and pension funds depends on where your investor or the admin has invested this money. So there's been a lot of fraud that's happened before where investors have taken money and invested it or have stolen the money, like Steinhoff. Go Google Steinhoff and have a look at what's happened there. There's a great documentary on Showmax about that. Very good. So the risk depends on where the admin has invested. Mm-hmm. What is the return on your investment? Again, it's dependent on the decisions made by the investment manager. Where has he or she invested your money? Hopefully, it's a diversified portfolio. Don't forget, with your retirement annuity and pension funds, there is admin costs and management fees, which reduces your return on investment. What is the time long term? 40 to 45 years. Your retirement annuity, grade 12s, as soon as you first start working, you take out a retirement annuity and you pay 500 Rand in or 1,000 Rand in every month and you just leave it. Okay. So what are some of the issues? Well, people wait too long to start making a provision. You end up at being 40 and then think, oh, I haven't saved enough for when I retire. Another issue is people live longer. 55 years is so young. It is such a young age. So people are living much longer than 65, 75, 85 years old. The older we get, the more medical money is needed. So that's why it's so important to have a retirement annuity. There are a loss of benefits when you retire. Remember, I said you can never be in the same position as where you are now, where you're working and you've got a car allowance, a cell phone allowance, petrol allowance. You don't have that with your pension or retirement annuity. And when you change jobs, your pension generally gets paid out. Do not spend that money. Go in and invest that money. So a retirement annuity, pension fund, a very important investment option. Right, let's look at the last one we'll look at now, and then the rest will be in part three. Another new word, endowment. Endowment. It's just a fancy word for a long-term savings plan. Boom. So what you do is you'll put a lump sum in, or you're going to contribute monthly to an endowment. And basically, the investor will get the full amount after the policy matures, 5 to 10 years. So I know a lot of my friends have taken out endowments to save for their children's university, to save for the wedding. So they take it out over 5 years and that money just gets put in every month because it's a form of savings. What is the risk? Again, you need to choose the risk profile. High risk, they're going to take that endowment and they're going to put it into equities. A low risk will be a more balanced portfolio. So your investor is going to look at your risk profile. Again, looking at you as a person. Do you want to take more risk? Do you want to try and make as much money as possible? But remember, the risk is also high. You can lose everything. What is the return on investment with an endowment? Dependent on the risk profile. Your management and admin fees also will decrease your return on investment. Remember, you've got to pay someone to manage your endowment. What is the general time period? 5 to 10 years. There is something called a contribution waiver. So that is if the contributor suffers ill health or is disabled and you are unable to contribute, you can then take out a contribution waiver. You'd probably have to pay more money for the endowment. It's a little bit of an insurance with the endowment, but it's in case you get sick, in case you aren't able to pay, in case you don't have a job. You will then take out a little bit more. You'll pay a little bit more every month for this. But in the event something happens, the insurer who has got your endowment will then pay out your full endowment. Remember, with an endowment, it's a monthly payment. You have to pay every single month. If you don't pay 1 month, you lose the endowments. It's a contract that you have signed with someone. Okay. Grade 12s, I hope that helps you. And I will see you in the next section where we will continue and finish off on the investment options. All the very best. Keep on.